MSNBC asks Sarah Palin why she hasn't been sexually harassed, isn't prepared for her reply. Former Alaska Governor Sarah Palin was in Washington, D.C., on Thursday when Senator Al Franken was accused of sexually assaulting a Los Angeles radio news anchor in 2006. Hours later, Palin was asked by MSNBC's Xi Hunt why she, personally, has never experienced sexual harassment. Palin came prepared with a perfect reply, and it was clear that Hunt wasn't expecting it at all. Palin caught a red-eye flight to Washington, D.C., earlier this week with her daughter Willow, according to the politician's Instagram account. The mother-daughter duo was on Capitol Hill when Lynn Tweeden, the morning news anchor on Talk Radio 790 KAPK in Los Angeles, revealed that Senator Franken had kissed and groped her without her consent while the pair were on the same USO tour in 2006. Hours later, Palin spoke out against sexual harassment in the workplace, according to Washington Examiner, but said that she personally hasn't experienced any incidents because people generally know she is carrying a weapon. "I think a whole lot of people know I'm probably packing, so I don't think there's a whole lot of people who would necessarily mess with me," said Palin. "I don't mean to be lighthearted about it, this is a serious issue," she added. "It really stinks for women in the workplace that for too long, men have thought they can get away with that old school thinking that it's okay to belittle and harass women." So, now that Sarah Palin has so graciously revealed the foolproof way for women to escape sexual harassment from their male colleagues, where the heck are all of the feminists? Shouldn't they be all over this one? Shouldn't the pussy hat-wearing feminists of the world be out on every street corner with homemade signs encouraging women to go out and buy a gun? Shouldn't they be lobbying to make it easier for women to obtain their concealed carry permits? Shouldn't they denounce everything they have previously said about gun control? Of course, they should. But, they won't. And, herein lies the irony in the feminist movement. Those who consider themselves modern-day feminists scream at the top of their lungs for the equal treatment and protection of women, yet, at the same time, turn their backs on the most tried and true way to empower women to protect themselves. It is apparent that the left's disdain for our inalienable Second Amendment rights trumps their supposed love for women. In other words, keeping guns out of the hands of law-abiding citizens is more important to them than keeping Al Franken's hands off a sleeping journalist's boobs. If the feminists were worth their salt, they would put down their pitchforks and take a cold, hard, objective look at the facts. There is indisputable evidence that the best way for women to protect themselves from sexual assault is by carrying a firearm. By continuing to lobby for gun control, they are only hurting the women whom they supposedly champion. Coincidentally, just as the feminists on the left have been noticeably silent following Sarah Palin's revelation, they have also been reluctant to come out and condemn Franken for harassing Tweeden. Why would they not express outrage over his inexcusable behavior right away? Could it be because he is a high-profile Democrat? There is definitely an alarming double standard when it comes to the way we treat perpetrators of sexual harassment and assault. Indeed, it seems as though, if the suspect is a Republican, he is immediately tried in a court of public opinion. In the case of a Republican accused of harassment, the victim's story is the only thing that matters. Forget about evidence, it isn't needed if the accused is conservative. Just look at what's happened to Roy Moore. On the other hand, if the perpetrator is a Democrat, and there is photographic evidence of his lurid act, still, those on the left are reluctant to condemn him. How sad for the victims of assault that they will only be taken seriously if their assailant happens to be affiliated with the GOP. As Sarah Palin said, this is not a partisan issue. It is time for those on the left to condemn predators like Al Franken, even if it hurts their party's reputation.